Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being here today. Here's your daily news report and fourth stimulus check update. President Joe Biden is now offering all eligible Americans a new stimulus benefit. The IRS says there are a couple of reasons why you may not want to receive a fourth stimulus check. The two winners of this week's $75 Amazon gift card giveaway are Marie Treese and Roger Smith. Congratulations to both of you. Remember that next Friday, I will be giving away more $75 Amazon gift cards. Please enter my giveaway by subscribing to my channel, liking this video, and also leaving a comment below. Thank you so much, everyone. Democrats are moving towards their most consequential stretch of legislating, with major decisions left unmade as they wrangle over the size and scope of President Biden's sweeping domestic agenda. The months of July and August will render a decisive verdict on Democrats' so-called two-track strategy of enacting President Biden's jobs and families plan via twin bills, one with GOP support focusing on physical infrastructure and the other on a partisan spending plan centered on fighting climate change, increasing childcare, and raising taxes on corporations and the wealthy. Work on both items is nearing a climax, with senators in both parties drafting that centrist bill for a July Senate vote, and the Senate's 50 Democrats haggling over how big to go in their own party line endeavor. Some House Democrats are urging party leaders to focus squarely on the bipartisan bill, while many liberals remain skeptical it would happen at all. And House Speaker Nancy Pelosi has threatened to sideline it without an accompanying Democratic package. A failed bipartisan result would force Democrats to write one huge spending bill mirroring all their priorities. Taken together, Democrats' decisions in the coming days will define what may be the largest spending bill in history, offering their best chance at reshaping the federal government for years to come. Joe Biden's party has a rare opportunity with full control over Congress and the White House.
And now that the economy is back on track, we're making progress on the second phase of our strategy, ensuring long-term growth. That's what my Build Back Better agenda, including my Americans Family Plan and the bipartisan infrastructure agreement we reached last month, that's what they're all about, long-term. But to keep our country moving, we have to take another step as well. And I know you're all tired of hearing me during the campaign and since I've elected president talk about it. And that's bringing fair competition back to the economy. That's why today I'm going to be signing shortly an executive order promoting competition to lower prices, to increase wages, and to take another critical step toward an economy that works for everybody. The heart of American capitalism is a simple idea: open and fair competition. That means that if your companies want to win your business, they have to go out and they have to up their game. Better prices and services, new ideas and products. That competition keeps the economy moving and keeps it growing. Fair competition is why capitalism has been the world's greatest force of prosperity and growth. By the same token, competitive economy means companies must do all they do to do everything they do to compete for workers, offering higher wages, more flexible hours, better benefits. But what we've seen over the past few decades is less competition and more concentration that holds our economy back. We see it in big agriculture, in big tech, in big pharma. The list goes on. Rather than competing for consumers, they are consuming their competitors. Rather than competing for workers, they're finding ways to gain the upper hand on labor. And too often, the government has actually made it harder for new companies to break in and compete. Look at what that means for family budgets. Take prescription drugs. Just a handful of companies control the market for many vital medicines, giving them leverage over everyone else to charge whatever they want. As a result, Americans pay 2.5 times more for prescription drugs than in any other leading country.
Democratic House Budget Chair John Yarmuth told reporters, if you add the two plans together, it would be the biggest bill in the history of the country. There is no way it's going to be easy. After 3 months of plodding negotiations, Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer has laid out an aggressive timetable that envisions passage of both a budget resolution to allow a huge Democrats-only tax and spending package, plus a vote on a deal with Republican centrists to plow nearly $600 billion into roads, bridges, and broadband. Chuck Schumer will reiterate the timetable in a Dear Colleague letter to Democrats and warn of the possibility of working long nights and weekends to finish that work. The majority leader has been constantly dialing up the White House Chief of Staff, Ron Klain, as well as his members in the bipartisan group and committee chairs in charge of a party line spending bill, whose work will run into the trillions of dollars. Every Democrat knows that the partisan legislation could be this year's last big train to which they can hitch their long-sought priorities, and demand is high. Budget Chair Bernie Sanders wants Medicare expansion, and Senator Tammy Duckworth is pushing her colleagues on childcare spending. A whole entire slate of progressives want a major climate focus, and there will be restraints on spending from moderates and from the Senate parliamentarian on what can pass muster and avoid a GOP filibuster. So what are your thoughts on the current infrastructure plan, everyone? Please leave your thoughts in the comments section below. The massive rescue package that President Biden signed back in March, the same law that included $1,400 stimulus and the monthly payments for families that start next week, is now offering free health insurance to millions of Americans through the end of this year. If you've gotten or have been approved for unemployment benefits during this year, you qualify to receive free health coverage for the remainder of the year via healthcare.gov. That's a marketplace established under the Affordable Care Act. The health plans in the free offer are provided by private insurers and come with low or even no co-payments or deductibles. Given that unemployment has remained high this year as a pandemic has lingered, the field of Americans who might take advantage of the free healthcare is massive. At this moment alone, nearly 3.5 million people are still on unemployment, the government reported on Thursday. President Biden's stimulus aid bill has provided other relief to unemployed Americans, including beefed up jobless benefits through early September and a tax break on unemployment payments that has resulted in surprise tax refunds for millions of Americans. Now, for those of you receiving the child tax credit payments, one of the main reasons you may want to opt out of the expanded child tax credit is if your income will have increased for the 2021 tax return year. Right now, the IRS will use your 2019 or 2020 tax returns to determine how much money you will get. People qualify for the credit if they are a single filer and make $75,000 or less, or a married filer making $150,000 or less. For people with incomes above these levels, the tax credit will be phased out. So that is the end of the video, everyone, for this afternoon. Thank you so very much for being here today. I greatly appreciate you watching my video. Remember that next Friday, I will be announcing more winners of my $75 Amazon gift card giveaway. All you have to do is subscribe to my channel, like this video, and also leave a comment below. Thank you so much, everyone, and have a very blessed Saturday afternoon.